For ages, Megalodon has been hailed as the king of the ancient seas, a monstrous 60-foot shark with a bite that could shatter bones and a hunger that knew no bounds. Nothing dared challenge it, or so we thought. But the ocean is full of surprises. And deep in the fossil record lie creatures just as fierce, some smarter, some faster, and a few terrifying enough to make even Megalodon think twice. This isn't just a story about one predator. In this video, we'll have a countdown of the ultimate prehistoric assassins, the ones that could kill the king of the ocean, Megalodon. Trust me, you'll want to see creature number 5, because no one expects that to be Megalodon's worst nightmare. Before we get into challengers, let's meet the king, Megalodon. This ancient shark could grow up to 67 feet long and had a bite force over 108,000 newtons, strong enough to crush whale bones. Its 6-foot-wide jaws held more than 250 serrated teeth, perfect for tearing through flesh. But Megalodon wasn't just muscle, it was a smart, ambush predator, often going straight for vital organs. For millions of years, it ruled the Miocene oceans with no real rivals. Still, even apex predators have weak spots. Its massive size made it less agile in tight spaces, and with a huge appetite came huge energy demands. In a changing ocean filled with unpredictable threats, being the biggest didn't always mean being unbeatable. Now, let's dive into the mighty prehistoric contenders that might have had what it takes to bring down the legend, Megalodon. One of Megalodon's most formidable rivals wasn't another shark, it was a whale. Livyatan Melville, named after the sea monster Leviathan and author Herman Melville, was a prehistoric predator that looked nothing like the filter-feeding whales we know today. This beast stretched up to 57 feet long, roughly the same size as Megalodon. But what made it truly terrifying were its teeth, massive, foot-long daggers in both the upper and lower jaws. No other whale had teeth like that. Livyatan didn't just cruise around eating plankton, it was a full-on predator, probably hunting down other whales. Whales today are super smart, and Livyatan probably had its own hunting strategies, maybe even using echolocation, like modern sperm whales. Now, in a fight, Megalodon might get the first shot with that massive bite, but if Livyatan could take the hit, it could turn the tables with its speed, smarts, and power. If the battle went down in tighter spaces or deeper waters, where tactics and stamina matter, Livyatan might actually take the win. Now, let's talk about one of the ocean's sneakiest ancient predators you might not know, Basilosaurus. Despite the name sounding like a dinosaur or some kind of sea lizard, it was actually a prehistoric whale, but not your average slow-moving giant. This thing looked like a sea serpent straight out of mythology, a long, lean, and deadly creature. At over 50 feet in length, it wasn't as massive or heavy as Megalodon, but that actually worked in its favor. Basilosaurus was flexible and fast, using its snake-like body to twist through the water with serious agility. It didn't need brute strength. It was all about surprise. In a battle, especially in shallow or narrow waters, Basilosaurus could strike fast and vanish, hitting Megalodon again and again before the big shark could even line up a bite. The battle between Basilosaurus and the Meg would resemble a classic David versus Goliath scenario, reminding us that in the ancient ocean, survival didn't always go to the biggest creature, but often to the smartest and fastest. If this creature isn't already on your Megalodon assassin checklist, just wait until we get to the last creature. You won't see it coming. Like, literally. Let's shift from sleek and serpentine to something a bit more armored and explosive. Because our next challenger didn't just hunt, it launched full-on underwater ambushes. This is the Mosasaurus. This wasn't your average marine reptile. We're talking about a 50-foot-long crocodile-headed sea lizard with a powerful tail and a bite built for domination. It didn't just chase prey, it ambushed them, exploding from below or behind with terrifying force. In its own Cretaceous environment, with warm, shallow seas, with plenty of hiding spots, Mosasaurus was a top-tier predator, even known to attack other Mosasaurs. Now, in a fantasy face-off with Megalodon, it really depends on the setting. In wide-open waters, Megalodon's raw power gives it the edge. But in shallower, reef-heavy environments where stealth matters, Mosasaurus might just outmaneuver the big shark and land a game-changing ambush. This battle isn't just tooth versus tooth, it's environment versus environment, and that could make all the difference. But while Mosasaurus relied on stealth and brute force, our next challengers show that sometimes, brains and teamwork triumph over sheer brawn. Because when creatures like killer whales roll in, they don't come alone. Megalodon may have been the heavyweight champ of the ancient oceans. Massive, powerful, and feared by all. But even the biggest predator can have a blind spot. For Meg, that blind spot could have been a coordinated pod of killer whales. Modern orcas, reaching 32 feet long and weighing around 6 tons, don't just hunt, they strategize. With brains up to 2.5 kilograms, they use complex teamwork to take down massive prey, even flipping great white sharks to immobilize them. Now picture their prehistoric ancestors, possibly sharper and even more aggressive, working together like a naval strike team. One distracts, another flanks, and a third delivers the knockout blow. Megalodon, accustomed to solo ambushes and brute force, wouldn't know what hit it. Sure, in a one-on-one, Meg might win. But in a pack fight, those orcas could pull off the ultimate giant slayer move. Now, for our last contender, something you probably didn't expect, and I know you've been waiting for this. Here's a real wild card in the Megalodon deathmatch, the giant squid. At first glance, they don't scream shark slayer. They're not faster, they're not tougher, and they definitely don't have a mouthful of steak knife teeth. But down in the deep sea, that's their turf. And down there, they fight dirty. These underwater phantoms can stretch over 40 feet long, with eyes as big as beach balls, the largest in the animal kingdom, built to spot danger in total darkness. Their tentacles are loaded with rotating hooks and toothed suckers that can grip and shred like underwater chainsaws. And with a quick blast of ink, they vanish into the black, only to circle back and strike when you least expect it. Megalodon might rule the open ocean, but in the crushing pressure and pitch black of the deep, it's out of its element, blind, sluggish, and vulnerable. This wouldn't be a quick takedown by the giant squid, but more like death by a thousand sucker punches. In this shadowy battleground, tentacles and tactics might just outwit brute force. In the end, while Megalodon was the undisputed king of the ocean, it wasn't the only beast lurking beneath the waves. The seas were filled with creatures, each armed with their own unique set of skills, whether it was brains, speed, or raw power, that could have taken down the giant. Thanks for joining us on this wild ride through the sea, where we explored the incredible sea animals that could have taken on the mighty Megalodon. If you enjoyed exploring interesting stories with us, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. What topics do you want us to dive into next? Let us know in the comments. Join us as we get animated about science here at Animated Science.